Hello, 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 welcome, welcome, welcome to my channel, welcome to my kitchen, and welcome to my office. Today we are here with a new topic. We are here to talk about our chopping board, our cutting board. We do use chopping boards to chop, to cut, to slice our food. And today I have a question for you. Why should we have more than one chopping board in our kitchen? How many chopping boards have you got in your kitchen, and how do you use them? I am Mama Laurette, and I am Afrofusion Catering Services. Today, as I was saying, we are here to talk about our chopping board. Chopping boards are essential tools in the kitchen. We use our chopping board to cut our raw meat. We use our chopping board to slice our bread. We use chopping board to chop our onions. We use chopping board to cut our vegetables. So how many chopping boards can we have, should we have in our kitchen? So today I am going to answer that question. We should have more than one chopping board, at least two or three chopping board in the kitchen. Why? Because we do use chopping board to cut our meat, our raw meat, and we know that all raw meat should be separated from cooked meat and from vegetables. So we should not use the same chopping board that we are cutting our meat to cut our vegetables and our cooked meat. Why? It's just because we are trying. We are working very hard to avoid what we call cross-contamination. We are trying very, very hard to prevent what we call foodborne illness or food poisoning in our kitchen. We don't want to be healed. We don't want to get food poisoning because it's not good, and we should avoid mixing food. We should avoid cross-contamination in the kitchen. So that's why we should have at least two or three chopping boards. It's more hygienic, it's good, and it's helping us to be safe. It's helping us to work safely in the kitchen. We will prep our food easily, and we will prep our food safely. Working with knife as well, it's dangerous. So when we are using chopping board, it's helping us to cut, to work with knife safely as well. For example, I grew up in Africa, and they taught me how to cut onions. So I'm gonna show you how I learned how to cut onions in Africa. We don't use our chopping board, we use our hand. We do this, as you can see, is very, very dangerous because my knife is very, very sharp. So I will cut my onions like this, and I will try to slice it just like this. So I'm telling you, it's not easy. It's easy now because I master it. I know how to use it. However, for our children, we are teaching our children how to use knife safely, and we should use good chopping board. We should use our chopping board so that they can learn safely as well. So as I was saying, it's very, very important to have different chopping boards to separate our raw meat and our cooked meat and our vegetables. So here I have my wood or bamboo chopping board that I love so much. I use this to plate my food just for presentation. However, this is a chopping board that can be used to cut vegetables, to cut meat, and so on. Please, if you love it, if you like it, they are very cheap in the supermarket. Look for one, and please try to separate your cooked food and your raw meat. It's very, very important. Do not mix them. Do not use the same chopping board that you are using for your red meat and to cut your cooked meat and your vegetables. So this is the bamboo one. It's very cheap and very good, and it's very good as well to cut your vegetables, because it doesn't ruin your knife, and it's very, very good. So I love it. If you like it as well, please, they are everywhere in the market, in the supermarket, and they are cheap as well. So the other chopping board I've got here, they are color coding. Yes, as you can see, this is blue. Blue is the color of the sky. Color coding chopping boards are amazing. It's helping us just to know, to differentiate which chopping board should be used for which item or which food. For example, this one, it's only for fish. So this blue chopping board, it's designed only for raw fish and raw seafood. So it's very good to work with. It's very good to prep our food with this chopping board. So I have my red chopping board as well, which is very good. And if we see red always tell us, like, be careful. Red always warn us about something. And in the kitchen as well, red represents red meat or raw meat. So we should use this safely, because raw meat, when they are not cooked, they can be very, very dangerous. So do not mix your chopping board. This one is only for red meat and not for vegetables or for fish. And the yellow chopping board, it's good as well, and we use it in the kitchen for cook meat only. So you can use the yellow chopping board to cut your cooked sausages, to cut your cooked chicken, and so on. So it's very, very good, only designed for cooked food. And here I have my white chopping board that I use, that can be used, that it is designed only for bakery and dairy products. White chopping board is very good, very useful. I use it for my sandwiches, burgers, and so on. Honestly, it's very, very good, and you can see it's big as well. So white for dairy product and bakery product. And I have my green chopping board. Green, it's good for vegetables. Green, it's good for salad, for fruit. So yes, you can use your green chopping board just to cut your vegetables, your salad, your fruit, and do not use it for cutting your red meat or for something else, just to prevent what we call cross-contamination. Is not good. It can harm us. It can give us food poisoning. It can give our children, our family, food poisoning. So please do not mix up your chopping board. It's very, very, very important. Thank you so much for following this video. Share this video. Give it a like if you like it. Please remember to have more than one chopping board in your kitchen. God bless you, and bye-bye. Bye-bye.